And it takes so long to get people to understand what these ideas are. This is one of my favorite slides because it shows hand axes from two prehistoric periods. The one on the left, you might notice that when you chop with it, it chops you, because the place where you grab it on the bottom there is pretty sharp. It's almost as sharp as the top. And then a little bit later, somebody came up with a hand axe that was blunter on the bottom so it wouldn't chop you as much. And according to archaeologists, the period of time between these two was about 200,000 years. So you can imagine every generation, probably somebody sitting around a campfire chopping with one of these things on the left said, "Geez, this is hurting. You know, I'll just chip this away," and probably got burnt at the stake for going against the traditions of the tribe, which are probably something puritanical like work is good for you, and it sure it hurts, but and so forth. And then finally, probably by an accident, some chieftain of some tribe came up with the blunter end one and made it a rule that everybody should have blunt end ones, and that's how this change happened. So there's this low-pass filter to reality, and the biggest example of it is what's happened to personal computing since 1980. The low-pass filter has been so dominant that all we get is about a 60-cycle hum from most of these ideas from the 60s. Look at what most people are doing with personal computers. They have unbelievable resources. Engelbart's SDS940 had 192K, and it ran 20 users as a time-sharing system with 192K. We've got megabytes. The system is much less responsive than it is. The user interface is worse than it was. And humankind has sat down for one of these 20-year slumbers right now, bedazzled by stuff that isn't very good.